James Cates grew up on North Graham Street in Northside, downtown's historically black neighborhood, and he was living in the same house with his grandmother who raised him when he was murdered in 1970. He was known by the nickname Baby Boy, then and still. His grandmother, Ms. Annie Cates, worked for UNC for years as a presser or ironer at the university laundry for meager wages in a Jim Crow workplace. She was a central presence at St. Joseph CME Church on Rosemary Street, and she grew up just across the line in Chatham County on a tobacco farm with a rough father who was born during slavery. James's father, James Cates Sr., was stationed around the world in the Air Force. In Northside, he was known as Boot. So here's a summary of what took place that night in November of 1970. It was the weekend before Thanksgiving, and that Friday night, an African-American student group and the union were holding an all-night dance marathon in the new Student Union snack bar. The dance was very purposely interracial. The aim was to foster improved race relations during turbulent times. But only 2% of UNC's student population was black at that time. To have any kind of diversity, they would have to rely on non-students to attend, which was not abnormal. Northside's young people commonly came onto campus on weekend nights, even knowing that some risk was involved whenever they entered this territory that wasn't considered for them.
We've never been wanted on campus. You know, as a kid, you know, you go down there. I don't know if y'all experienced this, but
you
sell drinks at the game at Kenan Stadium and then be hassled by the police walking back home
till
you got off campus.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
Case getting murdered on campus at UNC, a place that I had worked and worked from since elementary. You know, shining shoes, selling sodas. You know, all those things and all the things you say, kicking you off when you don't sort of have any responsibility down there.
Right,
you
right.
know, get off campus.
Yeah, you had
know.
To be going to work.
Exactly. So for Case to get killed, it could have been any of us.
That's right.
Well, my cousin, my first cousin, James Lewis, got killed. Matter of fact, when he got stabbed right there at the pit, I was working out in the studio, so there was another guy working out there, and I knew where he kept his car keys. I ran inside, got his car keys, left there. I went down on Johnson Street where his mom lived, told her that he had got stabbed, left there, went on Graham Street to his grandma's house, told her, went back down there, and he was still like laying there.
And I wrote this while I was serving in and around Vietnam. The last time I saw you, so full of life in a safe place, was a cold rainy night I gave you my peacoat to keep you warm and dry, knowing I would see you again, full of joy and life, but it was not to be. To be awakened from my bed, to be told you was dead. But I do have our boyhood memories, the fun, the games, the loss, and the wins. How can I fight for justice in a land so far away when I could not be by your side to protect you? The pain I felt and the sadness on my Annie's face, I will never forget. You were my neighbor, my friend, and my teammate as well. I will keep you in my heart. I will work for change. I pray that after this tour, I'll be coming home. Rest, my friend. Rest, my friend. Be not forgotten. James, James, James Cates.
Heaven help the black man if he struggles one more day. Heaven help the white man if he turns.